In today's OBS Studio course episode, we're doing another discussion style video. Let's talk about the ways you can set up a more dynamic live stream that engages the audience a bit more than the typical gameplay and webcam setup. This is going to be pretty hypothetical and requires some creative thinking on your part in order for you to get the most out of it.
Are you tired of your streams or voice chats sounding like this?
Do you want the comfort and quality of high-end headphones without sacrificing microphone quality? Antline's ModMic 5 is the perfect solution. Their dual capsule microphone attaches easily and securely to your existing headphones and fits within any setup thanks to the modular cable system. It comes with a cable wrap to protect your wires and optional inline mute switch and sounds a little something like this. Check the link in the video description to learn more. I'm Meeples Fox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio course. I have many more videos linked in the playlist in the description below that should answer all of your questions. If you want to know how the course works, check the introduction video as well. Setting up facecam on top of your gameplay footage is a great start to connecting with your audience and making a great looking live stream. But it doesn't have to stop there. A basic facecam cam is the beginning of what you can do. We're mainly going to talk about some realistic ideas, and I will show you some of what I have implemented. Those who are super MLG pro at a specific game, first-person shooters, RTS games, and so on, implementing a keyboard cam, mouse cam, or controller cam might be a great idea. This is super easy to set up, just an extra camera mounted and pointed at your controlling device, keyboard, mouse, controller, whatever. This can be a webcam via USB, or a camcorder or DSLR with an HDMI feed running into a capture card or something like the Elgato Cam Link. And yes, you can use multiple capture cards or multiple webcams in one system with OBS Studio. I do that. This is how a lot of professional broadcasts work. Not only that, but you can get some capture cards with multiple inputs. Let that sink in if you've seen that as a roadblock previously. There are multiple input capture cards. If you have multiple computer monitors and use them for a specific workflow, you can add them all to OBS and use a keypad with macros or an automatic scene switcher to switch between them. Or you can go a step further and add webcams on top of each monitor so that you always have a facecam ready. Side cams are pretty obnoxious IMO. My live streaming setup has three different cameras. My main webcam, mounted on my primary monitor, which is the Logitech Brio 4K webcam running at 1080p 60. The Logitech C922 mounted on my side monitor where I keep my Premiere Pro panels for editing live streams. And then I have a camera on a tripod behind my third screen over on my left. I use this for my console gaming live streams, and the camcorder feeds via HDMI to another capture card. Easy to set up and makes the live streaming experience a lot more dynamic and a lot more interesting to your viewer. And that is what matters. If you're not super picky about privacy and have an interesting setup, you can mount another camera, such as a wireless security camera streaming over the network, or just a webcam with a really long USB cable run, on a wide angle further back to show your setup or during your Be Right Back scenes. Add a little blur to it and text over top to say Be Right Back or stream starting soon, and you have a much more interesting scene than just a BRB slide. And viewers get to see behind the scenes, which helps them feel more involved. You can utilize complex layout graphics or websites like TippyStream to make a more visually appealing stream with extra layouts, graphics, Twitch chat overlaid, views side by side, and so on. You can have multiple people streaming in one location too. Run both game systems or PCs into capture cards to the streaming machine, set up face cams for both people, and switch between the scenes. Think about how major esports or even normal sports events are set up and scale that down to your needs. You can set up an audio mixer to feed in audio from multiple sources, such as multiple microphones, your game system, a secondary computer for music playback, and so on. See my audio setup if you want an example. Some people even have separate game feeds for when they're in between matches of their main game. For example, switching to the view of a mobile phone game while they're waiting for lobbies to load and switch in multiplayer competitive first-person shooters or something like that. These are just a few ideas towards the unlimited possibilities you can achieve with scenes and interactivity within OBS Studio. You just have to be creative and have patience, and whatever ideas you have can be achievable. I hope this episode of my OBS tutorial course was helpful for you. If it was, smash the like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos, come follow me on Twitch and say hi in chat, and until next time, I'm Meeples Vox. Happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.